The Lord be with you.
I'd like to talk for a few moments about God's desire to bless His people. One of the places in Scripture He expressed this is found in Numbers chapter 6. Listen to these special words of God's intention. The Lord spoke to Moses, saying, "Speak to Aaron and to his sons, saying, 'This is how you will bless the children of Israel,' saying to them, 'The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make His face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift His countenance upon you and give you peace. They will put My name upon the children of Israel, and I will bless them.'" God instructed the priest here of Israel to speak His name over His people and to declare specific blessings upon them. With this, God said He would put His name upon the people. God wanted His name spoken over His people three times. Notice it said, "The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make His face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you. The Lord lift up His countenance upon you and give you peace." Three times. His promise was a sixfold promise. He promised to bless and keep, to smile upon His people and be gracious to them, to lift up His face, His countenance with joy unto His people, unto His children, and to give them His peace. We could say He promised them provision and protection, His glory and grace, and reconciliation and rest. It was all His gift to them. The priests were given the privilege to say these words in God's name, the very words that God wanted spoken over His people. And today, in many Christian churches, we use this blessing also. It belongs to us, I believe, as well as to Israel. The church has been blessed with every spiritual blessing through the Lord Jesus Christ. And we can claim this benediction through Him. And I hope you will today as I pray. Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, help each one of us to hear the words of blessing that You say over us today. In the name of Jesus, our Savior, we ask. Amen.
Now may the Lord bless you and keep you. Amen.
I know who I have believed, and am persuaded that He is able that which I've committed.